me tell you something. When there's a call upon your life and God tells you to do something, I don't care if Ellen, Mallet, Steve Harvey, wherever you may be, when my Father speaks to me, I'm going to the nation and say, "Thus saith the Lord." Come out of your ways. Homosexuality is wrong. Everybody got an attitude against this woman of God. Mad and angry. So Ellen said, "I don't want her on my show. She's talking about homosexuals. You are what you are. You just need to be healed. Don't get an attitude with her. Get an attitude. Try to get an attitude with God. Because he's the one that does the speaking. We are supposed to be the ears that's supposed to listen."
Yeah.
But no, the world went and turned it around. They tried a war against her. In her defense, every homosexuality that you see, from YouTube world to the other worlds, is cursing her, talking about how fat she is, how black she is, how this she is, and how bad she is. But I want to tell somebody, I'd rather do what God said than go to a lake of fire forever. If he tells you to speak to the president, I'll go to the president and declare that my God still lives and he reigns forever. You can destroy the body, but you can't destroy the soul. I don't care about no platform. I don't care about being before spotlights. I don't care about that, because at the end of the day, we got to be the angry God. When your book shut, when you leave out of this world, you gotta ask God, did I do what I was supposed to do? Some people wanna stand before an angry God. And they're about to tell God, "Well, God, I was ashamed. I didn't know what I was gonna do, God. Oh God, I didn't want people to dislike me, God. God, I didn't want people to see me like that, God. God, I don't want people to know that I'm really churchy." But God is looking for a people that will stand in the midst of a dying world and will declare to the people, "Come out of there. Sin in the name of Jesus. Come up out that life." A lot of people mad at her. Just remind me of Jonah. When God said, "Go, Jonah, to Nineveh. Go ahead and tell him." But he ran from God. So that would end in him in that belly of that fish. Down there 3 days, calling hungry. And all of a sudden, 3 days, it takes you 3 days to cry out to God. Sometimes you have to cry out to God, even when your toughest situation. I can mind Jonah being down there all black, because he in the sea where ain't no lights in. You don't know what the fish up there eating, hitting you across your head. The Bible said the weeds was wrapped around his body, wrapped around his face. And he was pulling on that fish, and the fish was swallowing him. He hit the web, these were all around his body. The weeds. He began to declare the third day. He began to say, "God, I know you speak to me. God, I know you hear me down the belly of this whale. Jonah, you finally go answer to the call, huh? God, if you get me out of here, I make a vow to you, God, that if you allow me to come out of the belly of this whale, that I'll do as you say do." Listen here. God shouldn't have to put you in the belly of a whale to heal him. God shouldn't have to put you in a hospital to make you hear him. I often hear Brother Deacon say this all the time. "Brother Bishop, I don't want to have to be rolled in by the EMS to praise God. I don't want God to make me cry when I can't hardly see to come in. I don't want to have to be so full of sugar that I'm even losing all my parts to praise him. I want to praise him when I have a chance, but I may not have a chance anymore. I'll praise you, God." In the midst of it all, you got to learn to hear God. That's the problem. People want to hear man. Stop people pleasing and start pleasing God. Why you want to please everybody? Why everybody just want to kiss up? You got a job to do. We're leaders, we're ministers. We are taught to preach what God said preach. It's not about what people feel and feel like. Church is a hospital.
Yeah.
You come to get healed, but you come to get corrected.
Yeah.
And if nobody correcting you from your sin, you just gonna go to hell with sin inside of you. Because everybody want to be quiet. They want to be scared. Scared they'll lose friends. Why are you scared of losing a friend? God reminded me, as I hear the Holy Spirit say, to tell my people, naked that they come in this world, and naked when they leave out of here. Everything you got that you're working so hard for, when your book is closed, God, to be absent from the body, the Bible says you're in the presence of the Lord. And the Lord going to ask you, what did you do, my servant? As a child, I called you as a prophet. As a child, I called you as a minister. As a child, I called you to be an evangelist. But all you wanted to do was be a people pleaser. It's time out of pleasing people. And it's time to please our God. Because God is not pleased with the way the world is going. He began to tell me it's so much further in Michigan and all these other states. He said, anyone that seed is coming up to me, I'm angry right now. And that's going to be some people that are going to pay. Because some pastors, help me, Holy Ghost, to say as you say. They get greedy. All they want is your money. But they not worried about your soul. All they want is a good feel good message. Some people are dying every day and going to hell without the truth in them. But it's time to wake up, oh Zion, for the glory of the Lord is revealed. Gotta get to a place where you please God. Nobody else don't matter. Gotta keep that space clean at all times. I will tell Kim Morrell, so what, woman of God, they hate you. So what, woman of God, they might not want you to come to their church. But you better please God every chance you get. Because hell can't put you in heaven. Steve Harvey can't put you in heaven. But you gotta be one that say, Lord, I'll please you every step of the way. Not about nobody else. So what? Can't you at your job? You at your job for a season. Some people come crying to me, they can already have my job no more. Only thing I want to tell you is that you go and that you minister. Because that's why you was there. That was never your job to stay. Brother Nadine, again, somebody told me, say, oh, Brother Nadine, I think he won't have a job no more at the bank. And I saw a vision come to me. I was in the house. The Lord told me to tell him. So the reason why he got you out of there is because there's going to be a bad robbery that's going to be in there. And people about to die, but you're going to be set free because you're asking God. You didn't have a choice here. You didn't want to stay there. God took you out of there. Don't try to go back to it. Don't go back. God brought you out of there for a reason. How would you all be giving him the best praise right now? They just robbed the bank. Took people's lives. Taking them and just shooting them in the head. Because they want to hold to the codes. Listen here, if I work for a bank, I don't care how many bankers out there. They come up anyway. I'm telling them where the money is. Listen here. I be in this business all the time. And I know where the money is because I'm the owner. The owner is there and I'm the boss over my side. Now I get to a place and you try to have me run to his side. He ain't there, he don't hardly be there no more. Now, he didn't show me where the money is. Now, let me tell you what I do. Bank robber comes into the bank. I already got it set up. I already told Marcia. Now, when you were young, they had a fire drill. They told everybody to meet at a certain place. But you got some people going to meet over here. I'm going my way. They just told you, sir, to stay with the people. These are the professionals, they're gonna show you how to get out the fire. But no, you're gonna say, no, I see a window up there. It is 100 miles up. Why would you wanna go 100 miles up and the fire is gonna blaze up? First thing collapses the top. So why would you wanna go wait up there? You think you're raving to the people? And your airplane zoom. Now you try to go back down. You have to be able to follow the vision and listen to what God is saying in this season to his people. When you have jokers on your boat, you have people that you know have a filthy spirit and a heart of not love. But they say what they say. You got to remove yourself. No matter how bad it hurt them, they're going to cry. But you won't have that demon that they have. You won't have that jealousy that they have. What you hang around is what you become. You want to become that person? Keep being around. Now you was clean in the spirit and fresh. And all of a sudden you started hanging around people that try to camouflage the spirit of envy and jealousy. All of a sudden you used to run to hug that sister. You hug that brother. Every time you see, boy, I love you, brother.
Talk about
it. I really bless you. He's a giver. What you need is connected with some snakes. You need to connect with some people that's no good. They don't want to see you fly. Don't want to see you rise to your new season. Don't want to see you get your new house, your new client, your new wife, and your new husband. Hey, God. They don't want to see you blessed. The Bible said what the same does, he comes to keep, steal, and destroy. So he ain't just going to come and steal. Mm-mm. He'll be too cool for that.
Ooh,
so now he got to do it all. The Bible said in that order, say the Lord letting us know. Listen.